Welcome back to the channel, guys. I'm Ty, and this is Dad, and this is Reaction Extraction. Today's going to be an interesting episode because, one, we're going to be doing the Weeknd. Two, we just did Ultravox Vienna.
Yes.
Which is very interesting listen.
Yes. Different.
Yeah, very different and, you know, kind of out there, not sure what to take about it.
Yeah.
And we just did that, and I kind of thought this would be a good song to kind of compare with that same kind of
So you want me to contrast vibe. Echoes of Silence with Vienna?
The way that it's like kind of like weird and interesting.
Great. I love doing that.
So this song was on, this is considered like old Weeknd.
Old Weeknd.
Like on his, he released three albums and then that became a trilogy and then the rest of his discography. But this is like his OG stuff.
OG stuff.
So yeah, this is Echoes of Silence. I think this is a remastered. They posted this not too long ago.
Okay.
But yeah, so let's just dive in.
Well, I love the compare and contrast. Let's
I think
go.
It's mainly the vocals that is kind of weird, but let's go.
The Weeknd and Midjury. Interesting.
Talk to me, baby. Tell me what you're feeling. You say you don't want me to come. Don't you pretend you didn't know how all of this would end up. Girl, I saw it in your eyes. And maybe I can read your mind. Expectations were not inside. You knew that talking dirty to me on the phone would get me here. Cause we both wanted to do this, but I could tell that you were scared. Cause you thought there was more to us, but you knew how this would end. No.
can stop it there. So yeah, I mean, I feel like this song is kind of polarizing within the like the fan base. I feel like there's people that absolutely love it, and there's people that just doesn't fit for them, doesn't work.
It's polarizing?
I feel like it is. I know people that love, like, they absolutely love this song. They play it all the time, and then I know people that to skip.
All right, let's get to the Ultravox, the Weeknd comparison. The haunting part of it with the piano fits.
Yeah.
I get it. The direction of the song, I get it also.
Okay.
Because, let's see, Vienna had a little more variation with the instrumentals.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Pacing-wise, very similar. I get that they're both polarizing songs just because of the other content the artists have created.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and if you stop and were to just look at these two particular songs for each artist, it's, you know, one song does not an artist make, right?
Yeah.
So you wouldn't get the big picture, but let's focus on these two. The Weeknd, it's like, if he's going to do a ballad, it's going to be awesome.
It's going to be good. Yeah.
Okay, so vocally, The Weeknd has that over Midge Ure.
For sure, for sure.
Okay, even though Midge is good and hit some high notes in
What do you think of the, like, the sounds of the vocals? Did it sound weird to you, or did it sound normal?
No, it didn't sound weird because his voice, it's like Michael Jackson on steroids.
Yeah.
You know, not the faster stuff.
Yeah.
But
just the tonality of it.
Yeah. Know? And The Weeknd has a voice where it's going to highlight the heck out of his, you know, his vocal range on something like this. You know, but when Midge Ure hit the high notes in Vienna, I really liked that also.
Right.
And the Ultravox tune stopped kind of in the middle to have its own section where the instruments took over.
Oh, yeah, that was nice.
And that was kind of haunting, and I liked that. You know, it's fascinating when an artist has a song like Vienna or Echoes of Silence that does stand alone. The difference is, you know, Vienna was Ultravox's, like, biggest hit.
Yeah.
You know, but this is, like, a Weeknd outlier.
Yeah, I would say,
maybe.
Yeah. It's a, like, pretty popular song, but it's definitely not one of his biggest.
But I will say both Ultravox and The Weeknd, their faster stuff, badass.
Mm-hmm.
You're just, I appreciate the variation in their artistic expression. Mm-hmm. You know, they can both go fast and do club hits.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but yet this stands out for me also.
Right.
So it is interesting. 1981 versus, you know, 2000 something. Because of that, I would put the Ultravox song as much more advanced.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And what they did,
I would say it's probably more innovative. Just like,
yeah, that's what I'm trying to say.
Like the way they use the bass in that song and, the way, how like stripped back it is with the piano.
Yeah.
And then the vocals come on and layered on top of it.
Yeah.
Something you're not really expecting. And it, you know, it takes real creativity to you know, execute that good. I think The Weeknd does it here too. But I think, Ultravox has it. They do it in a different way.
Yeah. They do it a different way. Cause The Weeknd, if you add anything to his voice, it's going to pop off the screen.
Yeah.
Cause it's already so rich.
Yeah.
But I do like the compare and contrast of 81 versus 2011.
It's interesting.
Yeah, it is interesting. That's one of my favorite things to do, and I'm always trying to piece stuff together.
Mm-hmm.
And these two songs have similar elements, and that's fantastic.
All right, guys. Well, you heard it here first. Definitely go check out Ultravox if you haven't heard it. It was called...
Oh, Vienna.
Yeah, Vienna. Go check that out. And thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed. Leave a comment what we should do next, and we'll catch you next episode.
Yeah, we appreciate your comments on this. Help us out. Let us know what you think. We appreciate it. Bye.